When we moved to Utah, we were excited to see all of the activities in the West had to offer. We shoveled snow off the roof, we went hiking in the woods with our dogs, and we took Jake when he was in utero to the Grand Canyon. And we were looking forward to having lots of adventures with our new little boy. We did so when he grew up. Jake grew up to love the outdoors as much as we did, and that was kind of nice. And we started taking him up to Jackson Hole, Wyoming, when he was pretty little in the car seat. He used to listen to Lyle Lovett in the back seat, and his favorite song was All My Exes Live in Texas.
Wyoming. On a river trip, and again, Jake was in his pre-adolescent years, and we were going down the Snake River, and it was a beautiful day, blue skies, just one of those picture postcard days in Jackson Hole, Wyoming, and we'd been down the river before, and Jake was comfortable in a raft, and Jake was comfortable on the river, and in fact, one of my hopes and dreams had always been that at some point in time in his childhood, as he was growing up and becoming a teenager, he might be able to spend a summer in Jackson Hole working for a good friend of mine who owned a river running company. In fact, it was my friend's river running company that we were with that day.
Jackson Hole has some of the best river rafting probably in this country, if not the whole world, on the Snake River. And we knew somebody who operated a rafting and expedition. So when Jake was 8 years old, we took him on his first rafting trip, and he loved it, and we went on several after that. What I remember about the summer in question was that Jake was a teenager, and he was actually, when you get to be old enough, you can help the oarsman, the main guy that's kind of your guide, you can help him paddle. And so Jake was on one corner, I believe, and you kind of sit up on it, use the paddle, and straddle the edge of the raft.
The custom, you reach a certain point in the river where it's fairly, seems fairly calm, it's fairly deep, but it's very deep, and the river guides often invite you to jump overboard and jump into the river and swim a little bit if you want to. Well, I didn't want to. The river was so cold, I didn't want to jump in. But Jake wanted to jump in, and he had his life vest on, as I recall. He jumped in, though, in a spot where he was right in line with where the boat was going. The raft was going to go, because the guide was turning the boat as part of his way of steering it down the river. And as he did, the raft went right over the top of Jake. And Jake disappeared. He disappeared under the raft.
The Snake River was running pretty high that year, and we went over Big Kahuna, or one of those waves, and off went Jake. And I remember all of a sudden turning around saying, "Where's Jake? Where's Jake?" We were looking all over, in back of us, in front of us, and never saw his head pop up. About 10 or 15 seconds went by, and we started to get panicky because we did not see his head.
And I wasn't worried at first. I figured as soon as it passed, you know, he would be there. It was only a second, two, maybe 5 seconds that he was underneath that raft. But when we cleared the spot where we had last seen him, he wasn't there. He had disappeared. And I was stark terror. It was a flash of stark terror that went through my mind, and I thought, my God, did something suck him under? Was there, a kind of a hole in the river that, you know, where the currents could pull somebody under?
About 10 or 15 seconds went by, and we started to get panicky because we did not see his head.
he was lost. He just wasn't there. And we had gone downriver some, past the spot where we had last seen him. And finally, as we're looking back upriver, he popped up and his head came up out of the water. And I can't remember if he was sputtering or gasping for air or not, but it was the longest 5 to 10 seconds of my life.
Finally, we saw him pop up on the other side of the raft. And what he did, and our guide knew exactly what happened. He went underneath the raft and it went over the top of him. And then he finally came up, and his dad and the guide pulled him up, drowned like a wet rat, and maybe a little shaken, but I think he started oaring again.
And to this day, I'm grateful and I'm thankful that I saw my son pop back up out of the river after the longest 10 seconds of my life.